Hello, good evening. Hello, Manuel, good evening.
Good evening, teacher. Hi.
How are you tonight?
I feel fine. I finished the exercise.
On which section?
No, well, exercise.
doing physical exercise. Okay. I thought you were working on the platform. I'm sorry. Hello, Monica. Good evening. Welcome to the class. Hello, Monica. Good evening. Welcome to the class.
Hi, teacher. Good evening.
How are you tonight?
Fine, thank you. I'm good.
And excellent, thank you. And how was your day? How was your day today?
Busy.
Busy. You have a busy day today. Hello, Kelia. Good evening. Welcome to the class. Ricardo, good evening.
Hello.
Kelia, how was your day today?
I'm great.
Oh, you are great. Excellent. And Ricardo, how are you? Hello, Roxana. Good evening. Welcome to the class.
Hello, teacher. Good evening.
How are you tonight?
Fine.
Nice. Okay, yesterday we were talking about, do you remember the topic of yesterday? What was the topic? We studied.
Okay.
About medicine.
Advices and imperatives.
Okay, thanks a lot. Thank you, Monica. Thank you, Manuel. We have studied advices using imperative sentences. And we have two types of sentences, two types of imperative sentences. We have positive and also negative. And let's see, for example, if I have a headache, what are some advices?
Take aspirin.
Thank you, Monica. Take an aspirin. That is an example of a positive, imperative sentence. Take an aspirin. Tómese una aspirina. Thank you. And ¿qué no debo de hacer? Using a negative imperative sentences. If I have a headache.
Don't see a cell phone.
Yeah, don't see a cell phone. Things. Don't use your cell phone. Don't watch TV. And what about if I have a stomachache? What happens if I have a stomachache? ¿Cuáles podrían ser algunos consejos using imperative sentences?
Don't eat so much.
Thanks a lot. Don't eat too much. No coma mucho. Any other advice for a stomachache? If I have a stomachache, Don't eat too much.
Good evening.
Hello, Francisco. Good evening. Welcome to the class.
Eat more vegetables.
Okay, eat vegetables. Yes, that could be a good advice. Eat vegetables. Dean, that was the topic of yesterday. Do you have any question about the platform exercises? Any question, any doubt? No at the moment? No problems?
No, teacher.
No difficult answered? Respuesta difíciles? No. Ok, solo recordarles, ¿verdad? Que esta semana tenemos que terminar hasta la sección número 3 y también hacer el midterm. Tenemos que hacer esa evaluación, ¿verdad? Tenemos que tomar el midterm, el examen de medio curso. So, let's start with today's topic. Just a second. Today we're going to study some places of the city and also some preposition of place. Do you know some preposition of place? Do you already know some preposition of place? ¿No se acuerdan de las preposiciones de lugar? Don't you remember that?
In, at, no. Under.
Yes, under is one. Under, between.
In front of.
In front of, yes.
So next to.
Next to is another one.
Across from.
Between.
Between. Tonight we are going to study some of them. And also we are going to study some city places. Do you know the name of some city places?
Supermarket.
Yes, supermarket is one.
Bank.
Books.
Bank.
Bank.
Library.
Library is another one.
Restaurant.
Drugstore.
Store.
Bookstore. Store.
Restaurant.
A restaurant. Okay, so today's topic is preposition of place. Let me share with you the presentation of this class. Just a second. I'm sharing with you my screen. Let me know, please, if you can see it.
Yes.
Okay, thanks a lot. Just a second. Okay, preposition of place. This is the topic of class number 6. Welcome again to this class. Places, we're going to study some city places at the beginning of this class. And look at this, this is the first one. Look at this picture. What place do you think it is?
Restaurant.
Yes, you are right. It's a restaurant. So what can we do in a restaurant?
Eat food in the restaurant.
Drinks.
Okay, in the restaurant, we can buy some drinks. We can buy some food. So let's look at some other example. You can buy food, you can buy drinks, you can buy desserts.
What does it mean?
Desserts. Desserts, postres. And also you can celebrate your day, you can celebrate a party in a restaurant.
Anniversary.
You can celebrate an anniversary there too. A divorce too, you can celebrate that with delicious food and good drinks. What about the next place? What is the name of this other place? And the second picture?
Gas station.
Yes, you're right. That is a gas station. And you can buy gasoline, of course. You can buy drinks. You can buy some snacks. And you can buy fast food, like pizza, hot dogs, sandwiches, chocolate, ice cream. You can buy
coffee.
Oh, you can buy coffee too in a gas station. You can buy chips. And let's see the next place. Look at this picture. Which place do you think it is? This in the first picture. No idea.
Mails.
So they are boxes. That is a woman carries some package.
Correo,
yes. But what is the name in English of that place?
Post office?
Yes, you are right. That is the post office.
Yes.
That is the post office. So what can we do in a post office? You can send letters. You can send package like the ones on the picture. You can buy some stamps. Do you collect stamps? ¿Alguien acá que colecciona estampillas?
My mother.
Oh, your mother. You collect coins. ¿Alguien colecciona monedas?
My brother.
Okay, like the las coras, ¿verdad? The quarter of dollars. There are many different designs, so we can collect them. And the next place is the supermarket. What can we do in a supermarket?
You can buy fruits,
drinks, food, snacks.
Yes, you can buy food, fruit, snacks, drinks. You can buy food.
Meals, cereal.
You can buy cereals.
You can pay bills.
You can pay your bills. La luz.
Candy?
Yes, you can buy cookies, you can buy candies too. You can buy some toys for your kids.
You can buy clothes.
You can buy clothes too. And you can buy some electronics like irons, blender, dryer, hair dryer, secadoras para el cabello. So you can buy those things there. So you can buy food, you can pay bills, you can buy toys, you can buy electronics, and many other things. Now a bank, look at this, a bank. Forget it about this, right? When it says body parts, forget it about that. And let's concentrate on this, a bank. What can you do in a bank?
Office.
We can open an account. We can open an account there.
Transfer.
You can make a money transfers. Transference.
Apply for a credit card.
Apply for a credit card. Make a withdrawal.
What is withdrawal?
Withdrawal is taking money off your account. In Spanish, retirar, hacer un retiro.
Yeah.
Make a withdrawal, hacer un retiro.
Abonar, ¿cómo sería?
Oh, you can say save money in a bank. So receive remittances. This is the one, right? Receive remittances. Este sería recibir remesas. Receive remittances. Pay bills. Make a deposit. We can use this phrase to make a deposit. Hacer un depósito. And the next one, cash a check. What is the meaning of that phrase, cash a check?
Cambiaron cheque, cobraron cheque.
Yes, cobraron cheque, deposit a check. Depositar el dinero de un cheque, ¿verdad? We can do this in a bank. So we can cash a check, apply for a credit card, pay bills, receive remittances, open an account, make a deposit, make a withdrawal, deposit a check. And what about a drugstore? What can we do in a drugstore?
Buy a pill.
Pills.
Oh, you can buy some pills, yes.
Buy aspirin.
Buy an aspirin. Okay, you can.
Pepto-Bismol.
Yes, to buy Pepto-Bismol. Yes, buy muscle cream too. You can buy medicine in general, medicine. Buy vitamins. You can buy some vitamins. Buy balance for your cell phone. Pay bills too. Buy cough syrup. Buy pills, as you said before. And buy eye drops. Buy eye drops. We can do these things in the drugstore.
Buy credit cards.
Pay a credit card too. Or apply for a credit card. And look at this. This is the department store.
Buy dress. Buy shoes.
Thank you. Buy clothes, buy shoes. So buy appliances and electronics. In a department store, you can buy some accessories, appliances and accessories. And electronics too. Algunos accesorios y electrónicos. Buy clothes, of course.
Buy cell phones.
Buy makeup. Cell phone.
Buy makeup.
Buy computer. Buy shoes.
Yes, we can buy all of these things there. Okay, things. So let's see, buy perfumes. Comprar perfumes. Let's see, what more can we do? Buy shoes, as you said before, buy cosmetics too. So we have the study department store, post office, a restaurant, which other one? Drugstore, but there are many, gas station too, but there are many other city places. Let's see, for example, this library, church, hospital, park, bus station, museum, police station, firefighter station, cinema, city hall, gym, school, high school, university or college, mall, and airport.
Airport.
There is a new word here for you.
City hall. City hall.
City hall es el ayuntamiento, alcaldía.
Alcaldía.
That is the city hall. Any other?
School.
Church.
Iglesia.
Church. Iglesia. Church. School. Escuela. High school. Sería bachillerato. ¿Verdad? Escuela donde sería bachillerato.
Secundaria.
Yes. University or college. Universidad. ¿Verdad? We can use both words to refer to the university. University or college. Mall, what is a mall?
Centro comercial.
Centro comercial.
Comercial.
And the last one, airport.
Aeropuerto.
El aeropuerto. Muy bien. There is one of these places near to your house.
Gym, church, and park.
Gym, church, and park.
Park.
Any other answer? Is there some place of this near to your house, cerca de su casa?
Church, hospital, park, bus station, mall, high school, airport.
Thanks a lot.
School, park,
gym. Bakery.
Me, church, school, mall.
Okay, thanks a lot.
Me, church, school, and mall.
Ok, thank you. Bueno, voy a pedirles de favor que después de su participación desactiven su micrófono. Hay algunos que están haciendo mucha interferencia, ¿verdad? Please, después de que usted participe, turn off your microphone, please. Thanks a lot. Thank you. So we have library, church, hospital, park, bus station, museum, police station, firefighter station, cinema, city hall, gym, school, high school, university, college, mall, and airport. And I hear bakery, una panadería, a bakery. Don't you live near a restaurant? ¿No viven cerca de un restaurante?
No.
Yes.
Bakery. A la parte de mi casa hay una panadería.
Oh, a bakery, ok. Así no se puede hacer dieta, ¿verdad? La tentación está a la vuelta de la esquina.
From my house a pizza.
Ah, pizza restaurant. A pizza restaurant. Mucha más tentación. Which place? Do you want to know the name? I had a question.
Yes. How do you say comedor?
Restaurant too, or cafeteria.
Thanks.
How do you say cancha?
Soccer field. Soccer field. Si es de fútbol, es soccer field. Si es de basketball, we say basketball court. Si es de volleyball, we say volleyball court too.
Okay.
Any other place? Okay, then let's go with this. Let's read this conversation. And it's, excuse me, can you help me? Is there a public restroom around here? A public restroom? I'm sorry, I don't think so. Oh no, my son needs a restroom. Well, there's a restroom in the department store on Main Street. Where on Main Street? It's on the corner of Main and First Avenue. On the corner of Main and First? Yes, it's across from the park. You can miss it. Thanks a lot. So what is he looking for? What is he looking for?
He's looking for a public restroom.
Thank you. That's the correct answer. He's looking for a public restroom. Who needs the restroom?
Your son.
His son. Yes, his son. And where is one public restroom?
Baño public.
Yes. That is the meaning of restroom. And according to the conversation, where is a restroom?
Main Street is Main Street.
Yes, there is a restroom in the department store on Main Street. El baño está dentro de una department store. Y la department store está on the Main Street. Where on Main Street? En la calle principal, pero ¿dónde? yet on the corner of
May and First Avenue.
Okay. Thank you. It's on the corner of May and First Avenue. On the corner of May and First. Yes, it's across from the park. Así es, está cruzando el...
Cruzando el parque.
El parque. You can't miss it. Usted no se puede...
Perderte.
Perder. Thanks a lot. So, what are some prepositions of place in this conversation?
On the corner.
Yes, on the corner
across.
Of...
Across.
Across from, that is another phrase, across from, and on the corner of, and also on. And also in, there's a restaurant in the department store. So tonight we're going to study these five preposition of place, on the corner of, across from, next to, and between. What's the meaning of on? As a preposition of place. And
sobre.
Como preposición del lugar, vamos a decir sobre, ¿verdad? Sobre. Si un edificio está inmediatamente después de la acera, we say on. Look at this example. Here is the X. It's on Main Street. On the corner of, it means...
En la esquina.
Yes, en la esquina de. On the corner of First Avenue and Main Street. So across from, look at this, is...
Cruzando.
Cruzando el parque, justo enfrente, across from. Next to...
A un costado o a la par.
And between.
Sería como en medio.
Entre dos.
En medio de. So look at the example. The department store is on Main Street. Here is the department store. The department store is on Main Street. It's on the corner of Main and First. It's on the corner of Main Street and First Avenue. Then it's across from the park. It's across from the park. Here is the department store and here is the park across from. Next to, it's next to the bank. So this is the bank and here is the department store. The bank is between the department store and the restaurant. So here is the bank, this is the department store and the restaurant. So here we are going to find the bank. So we use preposition of place to give direction. Usamos estas preposiciones para dar direcciones, to locate a place, para localizar un lugar.
Cuando se usa corner, no se pone Main Street and First Avenue.
Yes, we can say Main Street, the name of the street.
Una pregunta. Across es en la siguiente.
Cruzando.
Okay, gracias.
Okay, thank you. Es across front. Es como enfrente de, acá, cruzando. We can also use in front of. So look at this map. So here is the department store next to the Citibank. And here is the restaurant. So this is the map of that city. Which places can we find in this map? ¿Qué lugares puede identificar en este mapa? Can you tell me?
Department stores, Citibank,
hospital,
supermarket,
post office.
Coffee shop.
Restaurant. Banco.
Bookstores.
Gas station.
Drugstore.
Supermarket.
Yes, you're right. So we have here a bookstore. Yes. Post office. U.S. post office. Doctor, hospital, gas station, a park, department store, City Bank, Maria's restaurant, David's drugstore, P&J supermarket, favorite shoes, Al's coffee shop, and a movie theater or cinema. So the names of the strip, we have First Avenue, Main Street, Park Street, Second Avenue, Center Street. So I have some question for you. Let's see, for example, where is the Second Avenue bookstore? Where is? We are going to use this question.
Corner Second Avenue and Center Street.
Thank you. Very good answer. Thanks a lot. The bookstore is on the corner of Center Street and Second Avenue. Here in this Center and Second Avenue. So where is the shoe shop called Favorite Shoes?
It's on
across supermarket.
Supermarkets and Second Avenue.
Okay, it's on Second Avenue. Favorite Shoes, it's across from the supermarket. Otra referencia.
Main Street.
Main Street.
Next to
Al's Coffee Shop.
Okay, it's next to Al's Coffee Shop and it's in the corner of
On Main Street, in front of
P&J
supermarket.
Okay, excellent. So where is Maria's restaurant? Where's Maria's restaurant?
On Main Street.
Next to City Bank.
Okay.
Across cinema.
On the across from
cinema.
Okay, across from the cinema, or we can say across from the supermarket. On Main Street, we can say
on that. Main Street next to the bank.
Next to the bank, yes, or we can say in the corner of. On the Main corner Street of Main and Street, Second Avenue.
Teacher, one question.
Tell me, what is your question?
En El Salvador damos direcciones del lugar de donde estemos, pero tengo entendido que hay algunos países donde se dan direcciones dependiendo de una ubicación específica, por decir algo, del norte hacia el sur o algo por el estilo, o sea, en un orden. No sé si aquí aplica, porque yo, por ejemplo, puedo decir... Next to Citibank está el restaurant María, pero puede ser que la otra persona se ubique desde la otra posición.
Okay, don't worry. Today is the first topic about this. Today we are just studying the preposition of place. Tomorrow we are going to study giving direction. Let's see, for example, if you are here at this point, you are in this park and you want to go to the Second Avenue. Y entonces vamos a aprender a dar esas direcciones, ¿verdad? ¿Dónde tengo que irme hasta llegar al bookstore? But we're going to study that tomorrow. So we can say walk one block or go straight First Avenue, then turn right, gire a la derecha on Center Street, and you are going to see the bookstore on the corner of, or the bookstore is on the corner of. So we are going to learn that tomorrow, how to give those directions. So don't worry. Mañana vamos a aprender eso, ¿de acuerdo? That is the next topic.
Okay.
So I have a couple of questions for you. Where is the post office in this map? Where is the post office? Using the preposition of place. Tell me.
Next to hospital?
Next to?
doctor's hospital?
Yes, thank you. It's next to doctor's hospital. That is a nice is,
is on Center Street.
It's on Center Street.
It's
across Adventure Bookstore.
Okay, thank you. It's across from the bookstore. And it is on Center Street. Y podemos decir una ubicación más. It's on the corner of Second Avenue and Center Street.
Great.
Next question. What is the department store? What is the department store?
On the corner of Fields Avenue and Main State.
Thank you. On the corner of First Avenue and Main Street. ¿Alguna otra referencia?
Across the park.
It's across from the park.
Across
yes.
from the park.
Any other reference?
It's next to
City Bank. Al's Coffee Shop.
It's next to Al's Coffee Shop? No. It's next to the?
Citibank.
It's next to the Citibank. Next question. Look at the next question. Where is the gas station? Where is the gas station?
On the First Avenue?
It's on the First Avenue, yes, thank you.
Next to the hospital?
We can say next to the hospital because it is avenue.
Across from Doctor's Hospital?
Across from, yes. Or across from the parking lot, too.
Parking lot.
This is the parking lot. Next question. Where's the restaurant? Where's the restaurant?
Main second.
It's...
Restaurant, main.
Next to a Citibank. Okay, it's on Main Street. Yes, it's next to the Citibank. That is a good answer too.
It's in the corner Second Avenue.
It's on the corner of Second Avenue and
next to Citibank.
Main Street.
Okay, it's on the corner of Second Avenue and Main Street. And also it is next to the bank.
In front of cinema, creo que.
Yes, in front of the movie theater or in front of the cinema. Yes. Next one, where's the shoe store? Where's the shoe store?
Second Avenue.
Yes, it's on Second Avenue.
In front of a supermarket.
In front of a supermarket.
Across from movie theater.
Across from the movie theater, yes. And also it's next to?
Next to coffee shop.
Next to Al's coffee shop. Things. And the last one, where's the drugstore? What is the drugstore?
On Second, drugstore on Second Avenue?
Yes, it's on Second Avenue.
It's next to a supermarket.
Next to supermarket.
It's next to the supermarket, yes. Okay, thanks a lot. Very good job. So the preposition we studied tonight are between. For example, the Citibank is between Maria's restaurant and Love department store. On the corner of, for example, US Post Office is on the corner of Center Street and Second Avenue. Also, we study next to, let's see, favorite shoes. is next to Alt Coffee Shop. And we are studying on. And you say Doctor Hospital is on Center Street. And we also studied across from the department store. Louvre department store is across from the park. So those are the preposition of play we studied tonight. So let's continue with this. Conversation practice. You are going to practice in a small group and you are going to share with your classmate which places or what places are there in your neighborhood. ¿Cuáles lugares de los que vimos hoy hay en su vecindario o in your city? And use the preposition of place para localizar alguno de esos lugares. Let's see, for example, the church is next to the bakery. The church is on Main Street. And you are going to use across from, between, on, and behind. Look at this. Do you know the meaning of this preposition of place? Behind.
What is in behind?
Behind atrás. Means atrás de. Muy bien, atrás de. So, is it clear what you're going to do? You are going to share with your classmate. Vamos a dividirnos en pequeños grupos y vamos a compartir con nuestros compañeros qué lugares de los que aprendimos el día de hoy hay en nuestro vecindario, en nuestra colonia o en nuestra ciudad, ¿de acuerdo? So we are 22. Bueno, ¿tienen alguna pregunta de la actividad que vamos a hacer? Questions?
Practics.
Dígame, Manuel.
Why is the W question used in this example?
Oh, okay. I'm going to show you. Give me a second. I'm going to share with you this.
Where is? Yes, no.
Okay, what? Lo primero que vamos a hacer en la actividad es lo siguiente. What places are there in your neighborhood? Neighborhood or city? ¿Qué lugares hay? What places? What places are there in your neighborhood? ¿Qué lugares hay en ese? A cinema, movie theater, a parking lot, a bakery, a cemetery, un cementerio, a graveyard, a funeral chapel. So, the next question. Por ejemplo, si su compañero le dice, there is a church, hay una iglesia. Then you say, where?
Supermarket.
Where is the church? ¿Dónde está la iglesia? Y él va a decir, the church is next to the hospital. No tiene que ser cierto. No tiene que ser cierto. Sino que es para que practiquemos.
Hardware store.
Y así vamos. Si su compañero le dice que hay un soccer field. There is a soccer. There is a soccer field. Entonces usted le pregunta, where is the soccer field? Where is the soccer field? Y su compañero le responde, the soccer field is next to the park. For example, the soccer field is next to the park.
Excellent, teacher.
Okay, any other question?
Ferretería sería hardware store.
And like this one. Hardware store. Like this one. Yeah, hardware store. You can see that. Any other question? No, okay.
Ready.
Are you ready then? ¿Están listos? Yes.
Yes, teacher.
Here we go then. Where is the option? Here. We are going to make tonight 7 groups. So here we go. Francisco, ¿recibió la invitación para moverse a la sala?
What is the fear? Okay, Heidi, what places are there in your neighborhood? What places are there in your neighborhood?
Se me olvidó cómo se dice la panadería, que es lo que está más cerca.
There are bakery.
Dry bakery.
Bakery, okay.
Bakery and supermarket.
Bakery and supermarket. What is the bakery? Thanks, teacher.
Tradicional. No es una reconocida, sino que es artesanal.
Okay. Where is the bakery? Next to, front across, next to your home. The bakery next to your home.
And pizza. Es una panadería que hace pizza.
So pizza, sir, candy bread.
Okay. Bellas. Vanessa, and where is the bakery? ¿Dónde está ubicada la panadería? ¿Hay algún lugar cerca? You could say next to the church, in front of the park.
My house. ¿Cómo decir a un lado? Porque o a la par. Porque está
next
justo
to.
A la par de mi casa.
Next to. Then the bakery is next to my house.
My house.
Yes, that's the correct sentence. The bakery is next to my house. Like this one. The bakery is next to my house.
It's a delicious temptation.
Yes. No diet. You can't not do it.
Yeah, go on a diet.
It's engordación.
Engordation.
Engordation.
What about
Coca-Cola?
You? You can buy Coca-Cola okay. there too.
Prado, pizza, and Coca-Cola. I like.
I like it.
I like it too. And Manuel, what places are there near to your house?
The gym next to my house.
Okay.
And across front, pizzeria, pizza restaurant.
Station police.
Police station.
I'm sorry, police station.
No okay. problem, we are learning, don't worry. And what about Francisco?
Hello.
Hello, Francisco. What places are there near to your house?
Cancha, soccer field, the shop, and bakery.
Okay, thank you. You say a shop, bakery, and soccer field. Oh, he received a message. And where's the bakery? Un punto de referencia is next to the soccer field.
Next to the shop.
Oh, next to the shop. The bakery is next to the shop. Okay, so what can we buy in that bakery? ¿Qué podemos comprar en esa panadería?
The church.
Ah, can you please repeat? Sorry.
How do you say churros?
Churros. We can say snacks.
Spanish churros.
No, we say snacks, right? Oh, all of them is a group. Churritos.
Elote loco.
No.
By what do you say? Cinnamon rolls, for example, in the bakery, cinnamon rolls.
What is that?
Coffee cake.
Cupcakes. Cinnamon rolls.
Cupcakes or coffee cake is in the cinnamon roll.
In the bakery.
Yeah. I don't know that word.
Quequito. Quequito in Spanish.
Semita preferecha santaneca.
Okay, now let's see.
Cupcakes, cakes.
Okay, then now they'll discuss, right? What you can buy in some places. Let's see, for example, on the mall. What can you buy there? On a restaurant. In a restaurant, what you can buy? Discuss about that. See you in a minute.
Okay. I can buy a wine in a restaurant.
Yes.
Campero restaurant.
What can you buy at Campero restaurant?
I can buy a wings.
Okay, wings with barbecue sauce.
Oliver Garden restaurant.
Okay, Olive Garden restaurant. What can you buy there?
Italian food.
Oh, Italian food. And what can you buy?
Mexican food.
Do you like Mexican food?
Yeah, I like.
Also.
Okay, continue sharing. Continúen practicando entre ustedes. Voy a visitar otro grupo con sus compañeros. See you in a minute. Sure.
Where you at the school?
Mm-hmm. Hello, did you finish? Terminaron?
Hello,
Marlon, hello, Rosa, hello, Noel. Which places are near to your house? ¿Qué lugares hay cerca de su casa o in your city, en su ciudad? Let's start with Marlon.
Okay. In my case, there is a church.
There is a church. Mm-hmm. Any other place? Church.
There is two school.
Oh, there are two schools. Excellent. There are two school. Any other place? Marlon, Noel.
There is a for salud clinic.
Ah, there is a clinic. Muy bien. Any other thing there? Church.
There is a park.
Ah, oh, there is a park too. Bakery, panadería.
No, pupusería.
Okay, restaurant, pupusas restaurant, or cafeteria, una cafetería, a cafeteria. Soccer field.
Yeah. Here, what do you mean, tiangui?
Tiangui.
Uh-huh.
Like second hand clothes. ¿Dónde venden cosas de segunda mano?
No, tiangui, no, ese es premium. No, es como donde venden cerdo, así, vaca.
Oh. When they sell and buy animals, tianguis.
Pero tianguis conocido en El Salvador, ¿verdad?
Yes, I guess this is a Salvadorian name, tianguis. But I'm going to investigate and I'm going to see you later. Tianguis.
Uh-huh.
Any other place there?
Bank.
Ah, there is a bank. Muy bien. Bank. Now, where is the bank? ¿Hay algún punto de referencia para llegar al banco? Where is the bank?
It's two blocks from the shore.
Okay, it's near the church, two blocks near the church. Okay, no hay algún lugar a la par de, next to, in front of? No.
The church next to the park.
Okay, that is a nice sentence. The church is next to the park. Okay. Bueno, los veo en un minuto en la reunión con todos, ¿de acuerdo?
Okay.
De acuerdo.
See you in a minute. Hello, welcome again. How was your practice? Did you finish? Hello, how was your practice? ¿Cómo estuvo su práctica? ¿Compartió con sus compañeros?
Yeah, very good.
Yes.
Very good.
Yes.
Yes. Okay. Let's make a list of the places that you share with your classmate. Can you tell me? ¿Qué lugares hay cerca de la ciudad o el vecindario de sus compañeros? Tell me.
Mall, park.
Ok, park.
Mall.
Mall.
Market.
Market.
Bakery.
Bakery.
Soccer field.
Shopping center.
Well,
car wash.
A shopping center.
Clinic.
Clinic.
Basketball court.
Hospital.
Basketball court. Hospital.
Mechanic
workshop.
Okay, you say car wash too, right? Car wash.
University. Car wash.
Mechanic workshop.
Mechanic look workshop. Out.
School.
School. University, you say.
Church.
University.
Look out.
Church. Hi.
No sé qué pasó, teacher, pero me sacó la plataforma.
Ah, ok. ¿No pude entrar en las salas con sus compañeros? But you can tell me now which places are near to your house. Which other one? We have park, mall, market, bakery, soccer field, shopping center, clinic, basketball court. Hospital, car wash, police station, any other?
Teacher.
Yes.
Drugstore.
How do you say mirador?
Drugstore.
Airport.
Slide.
Lopango Airport.
Side view, mirador.
Gas station. Gym.
Airport.
Baker,
Jean. Jean. Oh, Jean. Qué suerte tener un gimnasio cerca. Jean.
Trae más comedores.
Ah, ok. Cafetería. Cafeterías y restaurantes.
Pucherías.
Candy shop. Candy shop. Una dulcería. Candy shop.
Oh,
¿cómo sería una cervecería o algo así?
¿Dónde?
Beer store. Beer store. ¿Dónde? Beer ¿dónde shop. Es? ¿Dónde beer es? Shop.
Cadejo.
It's bad. Okay, guys. Do you have any questions about today's class? Okay, today we're also studying next to. What is the meaning of this preposition?
Funerarias.
And that is a funeral chapel, right? Una capilla funeraria. I have that word here. Yes. This one. Funeral chapel. That is una capilla funeraria. Funeral chapel. Okay, do you have any question about today's class? Questions?
No.
No question? Okay.
No, teacher.
Tomorrow we are going to continue studying this topic, giving direction. That is the topic for tomorrow, right? Don't miss the class, please. Solo recordarles, continúen trabajando en los ejercicios de la plataforma. Recuerde que hay que llegar hasta la evaluación, ¿verdad? The midterm exam this week. Si puede avanzar más, nice. Do it, please. So, rest a lot. Have a nice night. Sweet dreams. Sleep well. See you tomorrow. Bye-bye.
Bye.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Good night. Thank you, classmate. Thank you, teacher.
Bye-bye. You're welcome. Bye-bye.